Hey folks, this is Riker, with a video about the recently released director's cut of A Bard's Tale 4, Barrows Deep. This is a tactical RPG, a dungeon crawler, in which you control a customizable party of adventurers. It really has the feel of a classic computer RPG. And though I've never played the Bard's Tale series before, I've played plenty of classic RPGs back in the 90s and early 2000s, and this game really gave me that nostalgia feeling. Check the link in the video description below to learn more about A Bard's Tale 4. And we're gonna thank In Exile Entertainment for sponsoring this video. When I was first contacted about this, I was really excited to check out this game. Why? Because In Exile Entertainment and its founder Brian Fargo have a history of banging out great RPGs. We're talking Fallout, Baldur's Gate, the classic RPGs of my youth. It all started in 1983 when Brian Fargo co-founded Interplay Productions. In the 80s, they created the first Bard's Tale game, which was very successful and spawned two sequels. Interplay then went on to make post-apocalyptic RPGs Wasteland and Fallout. They established Black Isle Studios, an internal developer that would focus on RPGs. And Black Isle worked with BioWare to create the Baldur's Gate franchise. Then Black Isle made Planescape Torment, Icewind Dale. And in 2002, Brian Fargo went on to found In Exile Entertainment, which later released a spin-off to A Bard's Tale. But the first time you heard about In Exile Entertainment is probably when its Kickstarter for Wasteland 2 raised a staggering $3 million. I was working as a video game journalist at the time, and this was making all the headlines. The $3 million was three times their initial funding goal, and it really is a testament to the love that people have for classic RPGs and the faith that they have in In Exile. After Wasteland 2, they successfully kick-launched Torment, Tides of Numenera, which broke the record for the fastest Kickstarter to reach $1 million, taking only 7 hours. Then after Torment, they decided to make a true sequel to the Bard's Tale franchise and kickstarted A Bard's Tale 4, raising another $1.5 million. The game released in September last year, and now a director's cut of the version just released a couple weeks ago, which is a free upgrade to people that already have the game. So if you're familiar with classic computer RPGs, if you're familiar with Dungeons & Dragons, there will be a lot familiar about A Bard's Tale 4, even if you haven't played the previous games. And let's face it, they're from the 80s, so who can blame you if you haven't? As you progress through the game, you unlock additional party slots to include more people in your party. You're able to swap in and out different party members so you can build up different compositions. There's a lot of familiar races and classes, but there are also new ones and unique spins. For instance, could you believe this is a dwarf? There's something like 18 different classes, each with their own skill tree, so we have hundreds of different skills, spells, or abilities. The game itself plays in first person, as though you're walking around like your entire party. And then when you break out into the turn-based combat, we have this really unique grid style that still remains in first person. The combat is tactical. You can't just approach every fight the same way. I mean, you can have a standard order of operations that you default to, but you really want to be analyzing your opponents, what you're up against. You have to figure out how best to position your party members, both before the combat and during the combat. You want to plan a couple steps ahead, make effective use of your resources, your different abilities on cooldowns. You want to analyze your opponents, their weaknesses, make sure you're using the right tool for the right job. But I think my favorite gameplay feature has been the puzzles. There's a whole bunch of different types of puzzles. Some will be to unlock or open doors, other will be to disable traps. And sometimes you can find riddles that offer cryptic clues on how to solve the puzzle, and I'm a real sucker for riddles. Of course, being a role-playing game, there's a whole story going on, there's a lot of characters to interact with, fully voiced, and the voice acting is really top-notch. But I think the first thing that really struck me about this game is that when you first enter the city, it just feels so alive. There's so much going on, especially with regards to sound, that it's really immersive. It really makes this town come to life. You can overhear so many conversations going on, so much music and singing coming from different alleys and buildings and street corners. There's more than 40 hours of gameplay, and the director's cut adds 4 new hours of gameplay, with new areas to explore, new bosses to kill, new loot to collect. But the main purpose of the director's cut wasn't to just add content, but more so to really address player feedback. The devs took months to analyze player reviews, critic reviews, and so they've loaded this director's cut with a bunch of quality of life features like inventory sorting, which I found super useful. They've made balance changes, stability fixes, bug fixes, just to name a few. Once again, the director's cut is free for those who already own the game, and the game will now be available for PS4 and Xbox users. Lastly, I encourage you folks to stay tuned for a second video in which we're going to cover some gameplay tips for A Bard's Tale 4. Until next time, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please share it, and leave a comment in the video description about some of your classic RPG memories.